Is online dating the way to go? Esther Namboka Emeru, good morning.
Good morning, Brian.
She's the founder of Girls Forum International.
Yes, please.
What exactly is Girls Forum International about?
Girls Forum International is an organization, an NGO to be, whose aim is to equip women, mentor women, train women in making successful relationships and marriages. And we do this most especially targeting the women, because we do believe the woman is the pillar, the pivot, and the backbone on which marriage and family life dwells.
Wow.
Yes.
And so you thought about this, well, I think in the Ugandan sense, that is the equivalent of online dating.
Yes.
You created WhatsApp groups and single people meeting there.
Yes.
Why did you think, what made you start that?
Okay, when we started the forum, we came to realize that during the times when we would share some discussions, especially concerning the marriage life, would leave the single women out.
Right.
You know, they feel a bit isolated, and some came out to, you know, to say, you know, you people, how did you make it up there? How did you get your husbands? For us, you know, we go to work very early in the morning, and then we come back very late in the night. When shall we meet our potential husbands?
Mm.
So it became so much of an issue. And then it is from there that I got the idea that if you look at that today, you find that everybody's hooked to their phones. Everybody's busy on their phones. So if I created a platform that would bring both men and women together, not only for purposes of dating, but to discuss issues that concern men and women, maybe somebody or some people would get the chance to meet, and maybe they become something in the future.
You know, talking to some people, they were saying, well, this is, it's a platform for people to really, for people to meet and just have sex, that's it. It's a hookup place where, you know, if a guy wants to use a woman, they'll join and do whatever they have to do.
Okay.
Have you seen that? Is it being misused?
Okay, if you look at it well, everybody has to take a precaution, especially when it comes to social media. Before you get into too much involved with somebody, get to know who they are, their aim, their background, and also the admin takes the responsibility of vetting the people before they get on the forums.
Oh, so you vet
we vet them. We try to know a little bit about them. What do they do? Are they genuine people? Are they married? Because there's somebody who will come up saying, no, me, I'm single. But when you look at it, when you analyze it so well, the person is already married, you know, so they just come to just go. So it just takes a lot of effort, both on the founder or the admins of the forums, and also the people who come on the platform, to take an extra caution that when I get involved with somebody, I have to be very careful, because many people come to use with an aim of using you. Some people will come on the forum just to steal, you know, they're just thugs, you know, pretending to be looking for love. So it takes people to take an extra mile of being careful.
From you, the owners of the platforms.
Okay,
yes, you vet people, but what other measures do you have in place to protect, especially the vulnerable boys and girls that are genuinely there looking for Mr. Right or Mrs. Right?
Okay, what we do, we set up rules and guidelines that will be used, that the members have to use, you know. If we realize that somebody has gone against the rules, we automatically put them off. So somehow that has kept the members in the straight line, the bit of a straight line.
How many members do you have?
On WhatsApp, we have about 80 members.
But wow, so those are like two groups.
Yes. Yeah, no, actually it's one group, because it takes a maximum of 100 people.
80 people.
We have
on
80
one
people.
That's so much chaos.
Yes,
Esther.
Yes, and then on the forum, on the Facebook forum, we have about 1,700, though it's both, even you'll find the married people there, because it's a free sharing of both men, singles and the married.
Right. Yeah. I know you're bound by, you know, confidentiality and, what's the success rate of that group? Do you have people who have actually met and they're now dating?
Yes, we have two people. Mm-hmm. We have two couples that have made it. And just because we started, when we started this, it's like a try and error. Mm-hmm. How will it go? We want to help our single sisters out there,
right.
You know. But then we came to realize that two couples made it, yeah. So we are giving it some time. We can't say that they already have. Okay, we can't say that they are going to be married.
They're still courting each other.
So we have to give them time to build themselves, and in so doing, they came off the forum. Got off the forum so that they can concentrate on each other and see if at all something can come out of them.
Wow! Look at that.
Yes.
Is online dating great avenue to find a partner? Let us know what you think. You can call us live on the air. Also, ask Esther Namboka some questions. Are you still admitting people into
yes.
the forum?
Yes, we do. We do admit, but you have to go through a lot of vetting before you become a member.
That's interesting.
Yes, but Brian, apart from just dating purposes, mm-hmm. that forum brings men and women to share so many issues that go on in their lives. So mm-hmm. it's not only targeting the online, it's not only targeting dating. There's a lot that we share, health, career, you know, there's a lot that we do in
right.
the forum, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, give us a call and let us know whether you think online dating works, and looking at how many people uses forums, there are so many dating sites. At the end of 2014, there were over 1,000 dating sites online. Good morning. Good morning.
Hello.
Good morning. Where are you calling
Brian.
From and your name? Yes.
Morning, Esther. I'm called Sam.
Yes, Sam.
To me, online dating is like any other business of dating, because if you make some party, you will still take precaution. If you meet someone along the street, it's just the same. The difference to me here is that strangers are probably meeting online. Mm. But this is also a better way, because as we say today, like we say, we go to work in the morning, you come back late, we no longer have so much of the social hours within our communities. And therefore, what happens again is you could find every week I don't meet any stranger in the person of physical life. Mm. But then if I am online through WhatsApp, Facebook, I'm meeting a couple of people, new people. And let's not limit it to dating alone. I remember my first job, I got it online. I was chatting with a person, not knowing the person was a big person in some office. And before I knew it, she would recommend me because of what I was doing online. And there I was in an office and working under received history. Now, that's the same thing I would look at it in terms of online dating. You meet Esther Namboka online, take your time. You can learn her from how she comments, what she types, how she associates with other people. Then later meet her physically. Now, when you meet her physically, it's just like how Brian met Esther. And so you keep working out together, learning each other, and there will be history. So yes, I know very many people have dated and got married through online. So it's not disease. It's just being taking precautions like any other normal relationship. But to me, it's a way to go. I wish everyone to just get online. We cannot now miss any opportunities that come along. The most important thing is it stops to be online when the two people you meet. When you meet, now it's your business. You don't blame it online again. And that's the same thing. Even when you work at the offices of NTV, do you blame NTV for having given you but another girl for giving her a job that you've met and now you're dating? No. You met at office as work. Now, when you choose to take your business as two, then don't blame NTV anymore. It becomes your shit.
All right. Thank you so much
for
your call. Very interesting. He says, okay, you meet online.
Yes.
And you say, I'm Brian, I'm Esther.
Yes.
Then after that,
yes.
the business has nothing.
Yes, it has nothing to do with the founders of the platform. So it's your business. So you have to take an extra caution. You know, you see, Brian, if you look at online business, mm-hmm. everybody's going, most of the people are going to it. But there are people who have tried it and has turned out to be hell. Mm-hmm. So it's because somebody took an extra caution and went into it that some people are able to make a lot of money through online business.
Right.
It's the same with the online dating.
But doesn't it remove the traditional, I am at church praising the Lord, lifting my holy hands up, and then when I open my eyes, I see this beautiful girl, yeah. and I'm like, boom, yeah. love at first sight. Yeah. The thing that you're in a supermarket shopping and this girl passes by and you're like, whoa, yeah. you're on a bus traveling up country and you see the girl.
Yeah.
Online dating, doesn't it take away that element where it was the wow factor? But here I can put up a picture of anyone
okay.
and lie that that's me.
Yeah. Okay, one thing I would say that culturally, if you look at the African setting, we're a bit too sort of conservative.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we're still conservative. The idea has not yet been bought as yet. But one thing I would say that just the way I would meet a person in the bar is the same. The difference is that this time the person is too busy to go to the bar. The person is too busy to go for a rugby game.
Uh-huh.
So she has spent a whole day in the office or even on phone.
Mm-hmm.
So she's able to meet the different people, the husband to be, online.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it takes a strong soul, a person who is really ready to take a lot of risk. It doesn't take a weak soul to get into online dating.
Wow.
Yes, you have to be really ready for that.
You can call us live and tell us whether you think online dating works or not. Have you ever tried it? And also ask Esther Namboka any question that you have, and she'll answer that. We also put it up on our Facebook page, Morning at NTV. Good morning, you're live on Morning at NTV.
Good morning, Brad.
Morning, boss. Your name and where you're calling from?
I'm called James from Kampala here.
Yes, James.
You tell Joel to find someone online because we are tired of him opening a mastic, a mom and barbecue. He is journalist, for God's sake, let him keep his opinion. If he's tired of that, let him go back to social. It's not fair.
So you think you should get someone online?
Let him go and find someone online. We are tired, Joel. I don't like him, Baba Z. Oh, for God's sake, who cares? Let him keep it himself.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay. I don't think that was about online dating, but we'll definitely hook Joel up. Good morning. You're live on Morning at NTV.
Hello.
Good morning.
Morning, Joel.
Fantastic. Your name and where you're calling from?
Morning, how
are you? Okay, please step away from your television. We're getting lots of feedback. If you call us, please switch off your TV because we can hear you directly. Good morning. Good morning.
I'm very sorry. I forgot one thing.
Yes.
Which, because Brian asked a question later. You asked a question later about how it kills the customer tradition.
Yes.
When you're meeting online, it gives you, to me, much more chances to understand the person than if it was physical. Why am I saying that? Now, you know, they say the way you open up your mind or what your mind shares is in most cases who you are. So every time you meet online, be it on WhatsApp or Facebook, now remember, every day you're in a conversation or an exchange with different people. Now, through that, it is very possible for me to know your temperamental. Because if you're this kind of person who you're ever quarreling on the page, you're ever shouting, you're ever noisy, I know, okay? That one is a noisy person. That one is a very tough person. If you're this calm person, people come up with problems and you express them in a calm manner, then I get to know your attitude. Now, again, is every day as we share, I get realized every time this one is sharing good advice, this one is sharing constructive advice, but then the other one is the one who's always bringing kafuyo, 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 kafuyo all the time. Now, if I'm seeing this girl bringing kafuyo in the group all the time, I'm likely sure that if I date this chick, be a kafuyo girl. So
yeah.
Definitely, I also need to be a man who can handle kafuyo to be able to date her. So it opens mind of this stranger that you don't know, that by the time you meet them, you actually know the kind of aptitude and temperamentals and their mind more than if it was a stranger. If I met Brian for the first time, I don't know your mind. So it has taken me a lot of time to labor and understand your mind. But if we are met online before, I have had all access to understand your openness of your mind, what you think, who you are. And that gives me a better foundation to start from there.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's very interesting.
That's very good.
You know, he talks about, you know, someone, of course, I can judge.
Yes, somebody,
the way people
yes,
are according to what
themselves.
They post on
exactly.
online. And
yeah.
if you send me a request, yeah. I first look at your post and I'm
exactly.
like,
yes,
I
yes.
don't want this,
exactly.
you know, this.
Yes,
but
yes.
while that is true, mm. in for example, in your WhatsApp group, haven't you run the risk where people have made up personas or because they want just to impress?
Yes. Just the way I told you that we do a lot of vetting before you join the group. We came up with a decision after realizing that we had people who would call themselves different names. Mm-hmm. You find somebody, it's a woman, but disguising herself as a man, searching,
wow.
you know? Yes. So it took us an extra mile, you know, apart from you giving us your phone number to add you to the WhatsApp group, you have to give us additional information. Are you on WhatsApp? Are you on Facebook? Yes. Where are you located? Where do you work? Because you know, first of all, you have the confidence in me as Esther,
yes.
because I've handled you on another platform. That is the forum also. Mm. So you tell me where you work, and then I will meet you. I'll have to meet you first,
wow.
and then you tell me, okay. Even if it takes me to have your ID, shall go through that extra
so
mile.
Profile.
Just to make sure we protect
you
the
have
innocent
profiles
soul.
Of all the members of your.
Not all of them. But we have something about
you
most
know
of
where
them.
To go in
yes,
case something
yes.
wrong
you shall happen. Know so and so is a lawyer somewhere, so and so is an IT person somewhere. So it gives us the comfort to let other people meet them online.
Wow.
Yes,
that's
yes,
interesting.
Yes.
Where do you think you're going to take this? If I called you in the next 1 year and said, Esther,
yes.
progress.
Okay.
How many couples have you, you know, turned out?
Yes.
What's the vision of this?
Okay, just the way I told you that our initial goal of Girls Forum International is to build successful marriages and relationships. So we want to see most single people, and especially the women, especially the ones we work with, the ones we relate with each day, at least getting hooked, yeah? No, it's just hardly 3 months that we started, by the way.
Yeah.
And if you already have people, two people who feel that maybe they can take it to the next level. I do believe in the next 1 year, maybe we can have about
more couples.
Yes, more couples.
Mabel, I should remember you're married, but would you consider? Have you ever considered online dating?
I wouldn't actually mind.
You wouldn't mind?
I wouldn't mind if it was me who was doing it myself, looking for the person. I didn't like
blind dates.
Yes.
Maybe they like blind dates,
yes,
but
yes.
if she's the one looking for the guy,
yes.
it's Kawa. All
yes,
right.
Yes.
That's all we have for you this morning on Everyday Life. Go to Girls Forum International.
Girls Forum
right?
International.
On
yes.
Facebook,
yes.
and you can get to talk to
we have
Esther.
An NGO.
Yeah.
Yes.
You have your own personal page also,
yes,
Esther Namboka?
Yeah, Esther Namboka, yes.
Esther Namboka on Facebook, and
yes.
you can talk more about this. Continue that conversation. I've not been able to sample some of those messages on Facebook.
Yes.
We'll do it at the tail end of the show.